Who breaks the power of sin and darkness? Whose love is mighty and so much stronger? The King of glory, the King above all kings. Who shakes the whole earth with holy thunder? Who leaves us breathless in awe and wonder? The King of glory, the King above all kings. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. You laid down your life. That I would be set free. Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. Who brings our chaos back into order? Who makes the orphan a son and daughter? The King of glory, the King of glory. Who rules the nations with truth and justice? Shines like the sun in all of its brilliance. The King of glory, the King above all kings. Oh, this is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. You laid down your life. That I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing. You've done for me. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy, worthy, worthy. Oh, this is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. You laid down your life, that I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me.
Amen. Grace and peace to you from God our Father in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Good morning, church. Amen. You came in the cold today. Bonus points again with God. If you're a guest with us today, we don't do visitors. We want you to know you are part of this congregation the minute that you walked into the edifice to be with the church. And so we celebrate the fact that you're here. If you have any questions, we have a connection center out in the foyer. And we celebrate the fact not only that you're here, but you join with us today to be the body and blood of Jesus Christ. In other words, the body, which we'll talk about later today in the sermon, of Jesus Christ, which is God's church.
Now, there are several prayer requests printed in your bulletin. I invite you to please take a look at those. Special sympathies today for those who've lost loved ones. The service for Brooke Smith will be this afternoon at 3 o'clock. We extend our sympathies to Lily and Nick and all those in his family. Dosha Larson's father, Pete Goodwin, passed away, was 103. His service, a celebration of his life, will be next Saturday at 2 o'clock at Bigger's Funeral Home. So please keep them in your prayers. And we have a joy as well. We celebrate a new grandson, Clay Russell, to Helen and Arvin Merrill, and we're so excited for them, their first grandbaby. So congratulations to them. Will you go to God in prayer with me, please? Lord, thank you for this day. Thank you that we can come to you in prayer with our joys, with our sorrows, with our fears, our hopes, our dreams, everything. You call us as a father, a perfect and true father who loves his children. You call us to come to you. And you do lead us, Lord. We ask that you would lead us higher and deeper and call us into a closer relationship with you and a closer relationship with the body of Christ, which is all of us, all of your children. We sometimes have a hard time imagining what that looks like from your perspective. And even for us, it's hard for us to love those that we find to be different or unattractive or unfriendly. Help us not to be judgmental, Lord. Help us just to love purely and truly, to love your people and to love all of your creation, Lord. Again, we thank you for this day. We pray for those who are suffering, for those who are lonely, for those who are grieving, and pray that you'd wrap your arms of love around them, remembering that you call us to be those arms, the hands and feet of Christ to your people. We pray all these things in your Son's precious name as we share together the prayer he taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Our New Testament scripture reading for today comes from 1 Corinthians 12, verses 12 to 14. So if you have your Bible or you want to grab a Bible out of the pew, the New Testament reading, 1 Corinthians 12, verses 12 to 14. For just as the body is one and has many members, and all the members of the body, though many, are one body, so it is with Christ. For in the one Spirit we were all baptized into one body, Jews or Greeks, slaves or free, and we were all made to drink of one Spirit. Indeed, the body does not consist of one member, but of many. And from the Old Testament, Nehemiah chapter 8, verses 6 through 8. Nehemiah 8, verses 6 through 8. Then Ezra blessed the Lord, the great God, and all the people answered, Amen, Amen, lifting up their hands. Then they bowed their heads and worshiped the Lord with their faces to the ground. Also Jeshua, Bani, Sherebiah, Jamin, Akab, Sabetha, Hodia, Messia, Kelita, Azariah, Jozabad, Hanan, Peliah, the Levites, helped the people to understand the law while the people remained in their places. So they read from the book, from the law of God, with interpretation. They gave the sense so that the people understood the reading. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Thank you, Trudy, and thank you, Russell, Wendy, and the band. We are incredibly blessed and grateful. I want to talk to you today about membership. And it may take a little bit of a different turn than you expect. It's not a lecture. It's an analysis. It's not to impose guilt. It's to consider what we do as members. But before we do, let's pray. Heavenly Father, in spite of the nature of the presenter, may your will be done in the words that are spoken this day. And may it be empowered by the Holy Spirit. And I ask these things in the name of the risen Christ Jesus and all of God's church said together. Amen. We just finished the men's retreat, and it was a great retreat. We ate things we shouldn't have eaten. We sat around a fire. We did some labor to help out Glen Lake Camp. We got to know one another a little bit better. We're going to do those twice a year. So if you didn't make that one, please know twice a year we will have a men's retreat, and there will be other missional, essentially programmatic events that we are involved with. So just understand, when the pastor can't make everything that goes on in the church, you don't need to feel badly when you can't. And so what fits you, feel free to plug in. But we had a great experience. I want to thank those men for their work and all of their diligent efforts. I want to talk to you today about the word member. Now, the word member, if we back it out into the Greek, means part of, but it's an essential part of. Member is, in the Latin term, a portion of the corpus or the body. But we are not a corporation, we are a corpus, the body of Christ, which takes many members. And of course, you've heard the scripture, an arm cannot say to a nose, I can't smell. I've always thought that was creepy. You ever thought it was a little creepy? I don't want to talk about noses and smelling. But there are different portions of the corpus, the body, that we try and fixate on in order to wonder where and consider where our part is. In other words, consideration often on each and every part we have to play, if we do not consider it constantly and evaluate it constantly, can lead to devastation. And that is that the divestment of someone's experience can be a result of not experiencing us. You didn't know I was going to go there today, did you? When I tell you on Sundays, I want people to know you, I want people to know you. You're good folk. Sorry if you came in with another preconception, but you're good folk created by God trying to get this right. And you're going to mess up each and every day. Or at least I will. But I want you to consider something. You're a valuable part of the body of Jesus Christ. And times like these, we are always evaluating what our role is. Are we valid? Are we valuable enough? The worst nightmare in the world every year is to ask people to serve on committees. Because I'll be honest with you, when you got great committees, what you just want to do is leave them alone. The worst thing in the world, I had this discussion with Andy multiple times. I was like, Andy has been hijacked on finance for the last 48 years. I like Rhonda. She chairs finance. Easy to talk to. We understand one another. We pick up where we left off. It's great. That's comfortable. But that's not what God always wants. And there's going to be a day when Rhonda rotates off and goes, bye-bye. And the only thing she's going to be worried about is helping out with Lord's Acre or something like that. And that's all fine. But I want you to know, when you have something to give, you're being a portion of the body. And sometimes when people don't get to experience you and what you have to offer, the body is cheated and devastation or disease can occur in the body. Now let me break this down today. The biggest misunderstanding is we're not a corporation. I don't care what the U.S. government says. U.S. government says we're a nonprofit corporation, 501c3 religious organization. But if we really are a religious organization solely, why do we pay payroll tax? Amen? And I'm here for an insurrection. I got better things to do, and so do you. It is the way it is. Render to Caesar what is Caesar's. However, I want us to contemplate the nature of the body, not the corporate, the corpus. That is to back up into the Greek and Latin and say, as the corpus, who am I and what I am? What you are is Reverting back to the Greek, a member. You're a hand, a foot, a leg. None of you want to be a nose. Would you want to be a nose? Ugh. But it takes all the parts. One of the greatest illustrations was yesterday. It was like turning fire ants at a picnic watching these guys work. They took a pile that was the size of a semi, and I mean the size of a semi trailer, of the worst looking wood you've ever seen, where it was just this hodgepodge of piled up debris, pulled firewood out of it, split it, took tractors, moved it, shredded it into playground mulch. And at the same time, Brandon Reeves, one of our members that attends 11 o'clock service, whose expertise is flooring, is in the camp house pulling flooring up. And I think what was accomplished yesterday, because each and every individual member said, this is what I can do. And we had some people that had just recovered from surgery. They couldn't lift stumps. Yet everyone did what they could do. By the way, if you ever want to work wood with Ed Bird right here, Ed will pick up a 300-pound stump for you. I enjoyed that, but I want us to stay consistent with valuing one another as part of the corpus, not the corporation. Does that make sense? This is not a club. It is the body, living and breathing. Don't paralyze yourselves with saying, I'm not as valuable, I'm a hand, I'm not a foot. Don't say I'm an arm and not a leg. That has nothing to do with God's creation of how you are and who you are in Jesus Christ as God's servants. Misunderstanding can often happen when we're in this constant evaluation of what we think our talents are or are not. Before you get here every Sunday morning, every single pew, the pew you are sitting in has been prayed over. And I'm sure somebody's out there right now going, gosh, what a fundamentalist. Amen, praise God, yes. I pray for whoever sits in those seats and thank God for you being the corpus. But it's easy to misunderstand what your and my role is. It's easy to take into consideration the limitations that we have, sometimes being unrealistic and focusing more on the limitations of how we can serve and basically invalidating what we offer. Our identity is in Christ, and we serve where we can, how we can, and when we can. Amen? There's nothing worse than working a Sunday shift and somebody goes, you should have been at church. How's that going to work out? If somebody can share that with me, I'd love to know, because last I checked, I have to work every Sunday too. There was a man speaking at a dinner, and he realized he was in a hurry to leave his hotel. He'd had a great nap. He'd had a flight. He was out of state. And he woke up and realized he'd forgotten his dentures. There were about 5 minutes left, and it was time to speak. He was at the head table. And to his right was a gentleman that had brought in a briefcase, and it was a convention. And he said, I've got a problem. I forgot my dentures. And the man said, hang on just 1 minute. And the man underneath the tablecloth leaned over, and no one could see. He looked in a briefcase, and he pulled out a set of dentures, and he said, try these. And the man went, praise God. And so he put them on, and he said, they were way too tight. And the man said, how's that work? He said, they're just really tight. And they're bent over behind this head table at this banquet. Nobody knows what's going on. And he says, just a minute. And he pulls another set of dentures out, and he says, try these. And he goes, oh gosh, they're too loose. They're going to come out when I'm speaking. He says, hang on. He keeps digging through this briefcase. And this man's almost overwhelmed of why would a man have a briefcase with him at a banquet behind a table and tablecloths? Finally, he puts a set in. He says, these are just right. He says, listen, I'm looking for a new dentist anyway. Would you be interested? And he said, oh no, I'm not qualified. I'm a funeral director. We have engineers, we have accountants, we have record keepers, we have people that are organized more so than others. I have Kim Watson, so that's a different deal. Pray for her, by the way. But you have something to offer. I watched somebody yesterday trying to do something they shouldn't have been doing because they were worried they weren't offering enough. Sometimes your presence is enough. Sometimes we just want to be around you. The great thing yesterday was, and this weekend was, when men would walk in, and I think Jeff Mantooth will attest to this, and Phil and some of you others, when we walked in, it was great to see them walk in, was it not? Just to see them. We didn't walk in and go, what do you have to offer? See the wood pile. And some could drive tractors, and some could work the log splitter. Some could carry 300-pound stumps. Some could organize. But all had something to offer. Folks, the body, the corpus, is not a corporation. Can you imagine a corporation that just went into the red every year because they give money and food away? By the way, we're about to start a new ministry. We're going to start a store where kids in high school can shop for the prom and feel like they got to go shopping. So in a little while, I'll be asking you for prom dresses and dress shoes. And they won't be humiliated, and they will attend the Aledo prom. Do you know there are children that don't attend the Aledo prom because they don't have the money and they're too embarrassed for anyone to find out? That's where the Church of Jesus Christ steps in. Where we're going to put it, I don't know. How we're going to put it, I don't know. But the body, amen? No. The body, amen? Has something to offer. If you have an idea and you have a strategy, I do have a location that we're focused on, and Chris has been helpful in that. Stacy Smith brought it to our attention. But when we get these opportunities, we have to think. If you have a child and they're away at college and you know they're never wearing those dress shoes again or that dress again, call them and ask them, do you think it'd be okay if I gave that up? I know people are attached to certain things. But think about being able to provide that to someone and no one knows. And they get to show up at the prom. And because the corpus, the body, those that are more organized, those that are better at retail, those that have experiences and understanding how to give someone dignity, have another place to serve. What I'm asking you to consider this week is, what part of the body do you want to be? You're not a corporate officer. You're a member. The Greek word member means part, hand, feet, finger, whatever it may be. And as a part, you're called to be active where you can and when you can be. I want you to know that we're going to increase mission this year by twofold in this church. That is, two new missions programs. Pretty reasonable, but we need to do it effectively. Amen? We need to tie into something that's not glamorous. You ever heard of people that they just want the glamour kind of stuff? Selling prom dresses in and out of a little building, but not really selling them is not glamorous. But I think it makes someone feel glamorous. Providing food is not glamorous, but it gives people dignity when they show up at those doors and they're humiliated and we say, here, you want another bag? Do you know someone you can help? That's one of my favorite things to do. Do you know someone else that you could help? Could I give you another bag so you can help someone? And when they think they're receiving, they realize they have something to give. That's the body. So my prayer for you this week is to be in consideration constantly and avoid the potential devastation and not offering who you are as a member of the body in however you can offer it. And that's going to be my prayer for you this week, as it is myself, that we don't limit who we are. We remember whose we are as the body of Jesus Christ. May you be blessed this week in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And all of God's church said together, Amen. We give the invitation every time we meet. And the invitation is not from me nor this church. It is from Jesus Christ. If you'd like to be baptized, or you'd like to accept Christ as your Savior, or if you'd like to join with this congregation, our motto is you will not find a better group of people who are sinners just trying to get it right. Will you stand and let's praise God?
I meet with you and my soul sings out as your word throws doubt far away. I sing to you and my heart cries holy, hallelujah, Father, you're near. My hope is in you, Lord, all the day long. I won't be shaken by drought or storm. A peace that passes understanding is my song, and I sing. My hope is in you, Lord. I wait for you, and my soul finds rest. In my selfishness, you show me grace. I worship you, and my heart cries holy, hallelujah. Passes understanding is my song, and I sing. My hope is in you, Lord. I will wait on you. You are my refuge. I will wait on you. You are my refuge. I will wait on you. You are my
church. I hope you have a blessed week, and I hope you remember you're valued and you're loved. That is my prayer for you this week, and you are of value as part of this body. Let us pray. Lord, guide us. When we're unsure, reassure us. When we're unloved, may we feel through the power of the Holy Spirit your love for us. Inspire us into your will this week. And we ask these things in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And all of God's church said, amen.
My hope is in you, Lord, all the day long.